Jesus loves you, beloved ones. No matter who you are, Jesus loves you. God is our Father, and the blood of Jesus makes us the children of God. And whoever believes in him will never be put to shame. Jesus loves you, and whoever calls on his name will be saved. And beloved ones, the true revival is true representation of Jesus. We must all truly represent him. The love of Jesus, the love of Jesus and his character and his life, his divine nature, divine character, divine life and his holiness. We must truly represent Jesus. That is the true revival. That is the true revival. Jesus is preparing his bride, his church. He is preparing us all as his true bride. Yes, we have greater works to do. We have greater works to do. We have good works to do. We have glorious works to do. Much more in these coming years until rapture and eternal with our families and generations. So what you have seen, it's all for the glory of Jesus. Glory of Jesus. It's all him. It's all him. We have greater works to do. More good works to do. More glorious works to do in the coming years until rapture and eternal. Jesus loves you. Loves you. Loves you. His blood, his resurrection, he lives, and we shall live also, and the great Holy Spirit will do it all for us. Jesus loves you, loves you, loves you. Jesus loves you, Jesus loves you, Jesus loves you. God our Father loves you, loves you, loves you. My dear children, truly, God is our Father. He loves you. You can call him Abba, Father, no matter who you are. For the glory of Jesus, in Jesus' name, whatever you do, whatever we do in word or deed, do it in the name of Jesus for the glory of the Father, for the glory. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. And today, as we come to you, me and my dear beloved wife Suanti and our dear beloved one and only daughter Divina, we come to the cross and the blood of Jesus cleanses us. Holy Spirit takes the word from Jesus. Jesus is the word. He is the word. He is the living word who came in flesh and saved us. Today risen from the dead, ascended to the right hand of the Father, is seated at the highest throne in heaven. Jesus, our Savior, our Lord, over everything in our life. And he is the word who came in flesh. So Holy Spirit takes the word from Jesus and gives to me, cleanses me, and gives to all of us as multitudes receive life and life and life in abundance in Jesus' name. Eternal in Jesus' name. He loves you. One day, on a Sabbath day, in Luke's Gospel, chapter 6, verse 5, this is what the Holy Spirit gives me from Jesus. Luke's Gospel, 6th chapter, verse 5. It was a Sabbath day. And the Lord says, the Son of Man is Lord also of the Sabbath. Which means he is the Lord of all things in our life. Everything. He is the Lord of our life. He has taken full responsibility with all love to take care of us on this earth, always until rapture and eternal in heaven after rapture. Anyone, everyone in Jesus' name. And the Lord says, even the Sabbath day, he is the Lord, every day, every moment. And the meaning of Sabbath, which we have learned many times, is to let God do it for us. Let him do it for us. Trust in him. Have the fullest, let us have the fullest confidence in him, a joyful confidence that he will do it. He is faithful. 1 Thessalonians 5:24 says he is faithful. He will do it. So let us rely on him, depend on him wholly, trust in him no matter what you are going through, no matter who you are. Just trust him and trust him. And say, Lord, you do it for me. Yes, he will do it for you. That doesn't mean that we just go and do nothing and sit idle and waste our time. No, the Lord is going to do it. His strength, his wisdom, his power His love, His life, He is going to do it in us and through us. Bible says, Paul says in the Holy Spirit that I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. Without Him we can't do anything. John 15:5, but with His strength, His power, His protection, His wisdom, His guidance. That's why Holy Spirit is in us to guide us. He is the Spirit of the resurrection of Jesus, sent from the Father, sent from the Father by Jesus for us to live with us and live in us and lead us, guide us, protect us, oh, and strengthen us in His power and His wisdom and knowledge and understanding. Oh, beloved ones, comforting us, encouraging us all the time. So, and the Bible says He will bless the labor of our hands. We have to, beloved. We must say, Lord, You work through me, work in me, work through me. I just rely on You, not my understanding, not the way I want it, not the way in which I want it to happen. No, Lord, You let it be Your will, Your way, and Your works in my life. He will do it, and we must be ready. That's why He has given us a body, and our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is there to strengthen our body, heal our body, heal our minds, our thoughts, very important, our thoughts, our mind, our will. He is there to give us a sound mind, 2 Timothy 1:7, a mind like Jesus, with peace, with peace, with peace. How much He loves you. Let not your heart be troubled. Jesus loves you. He is the Lord. He is the Lord of everything in our life. Our entire future, our family, our ministry, are the labor of our hands. You say, Lord, I trust in You. I depend on You. Work in me, Lord. Work through me everywhere. He loves you. So He went into a synagogue, and there were a lot of people were there on a Sabbath day. And He saw a man. There was a man whose right hand was withered. Right hand, that's the hand with which many, many, in fact, all humans work. If our right hand is withered or disabled or dislocated or whatever, beloved ones, we can't do a job of work. We can't earn our living. What a pathetic situation. What a sorrowful situation. And he can't do anything. And how could he take care of his family or his future? What a desperate situation. He was in great despair. But he had great solace and peace and comfort in the house of God, in the house of God, because in the house of God, God comes and speaks to us. His word is there wherever people gather in Jesus' name. He is there to encourage us. His word heals us, gives us life. His word saves us. So he found great peace in the house of God. That's why we must be in the house of God. Never miss the house of God, the church. And the church where the great Holy Spirit comes, His great word comes, and God does great things in His great love, in His great love. And Jesus saw him. He was in such a desperate situation. No one would have known that. It appeared in the natural, he had no future. It appeared in the practical reality, he had no future. He just can't earn a living. He just can't do anything. Helpless man. My loving children, what a sad situation. He felt, I'm sure, in his heart, in his mind, there's no future for me. What can I do? That I'm a useless person. Useless person. Useless for everyone. And there Jesus saw him. He was in the church, in the house of God. And Jesus comes there. Unexpected things will happen when you wait for Jesus. Unexpected things will happen when you are in the house of God. Miracles, healings, blessings, salvation. Oh, beloved, every great thing of God will happen. And what you think cannot happen will happen when you are in the house of God. You may not expect it. This man would have never expected Jesus to come there. This man would have never expected at that moment things to happen. But he was there. having a joyful, silent trust in Jesus. A silent, secret trust in Jesus. Maybe he couldn't lift his hands. Yes, his hand was withered. But in his heart or mind, he could have. That's why he was in the house of God. A silent trust in Jesus. God will honor that. The Lord will honor that. He sees our inside. He sees our inside. Let not your heart be troubled. You're in quietness and in confidence is your strength. Confidence in Christ Jesus, the risen Savior, the living God. He loves you, loves you, loves you, no matter who you are, no matter from where you have come. And Jesus, he knew the minds and the hearts of the other people sitting there. There were leaders, there were teachers of the law, the scribes and Pharisees. And they were waiting to find grounds on which they can accuse Jesus. They were jealous of Jesus because of the love of God, how many people were healed and saved and forgiven. It was something they couldn't take it. Oh, and they were sitting there waiting to accuse and find fault with Jesus, with no love in their heart, no love. And Jesus knew their thoughts, and he told this man, stand, rise and stand in the midst of this, in the midst of all those who are opposing, he stood. There may be many opposing you. There may be many situations not favorable for you, my loving children. But if you can stand in the midst, Jesus, and trust in Jesus, maybe in your office, maybe in your workplace, your business, even in the churches, even in families, there may be people disagreeing with you. There may be people envying you. There may be people trying to trouble you. Don't look at them. You stand for Jesus, trusting in Jesus, that your whole confidence is in Christ Jesus, the risen Savior. Yes, he loves you. He loves you. Those who trust in the Lord will never be put to shame. Romans 10 verse 11, 12, 13. Romans 10, oh my beloved ones, he is here today. He loves you. He loves you. Isaiah 54, 4, you will never be put to shame. You just trust in Jesus. Believe him. He loves you, loves you, loves you. He lives to love you and bless you. And he stood in the midst. He could have wondered, who is this strange man, this holy man coming and telling, stand in the midst? He could have resisted. He could have said, how can I look at my hand, look at my life? People will laugh at me. People will mock me. But the words of Jesus is love. The words of Jesus is power. The words just went and grabbed him. Grabbed his mind, his soul, his spirit, his body, and he stood up. That's the power of the Word of God. If you come in the presence of the words of Jesus, he will embrace you, he will hold you, he will lift you. And he stood in the midst, no matter who opposed him. And Jesus knew the thoughts of these people, and he asked them, am I to save life or let it perish? He was piercing their conscience with the love of God. This is a moment of saving life or saving the future of someone, saving the life of someone. It's not just merely healing the hand and giving a new hand. It is more than that, giving him a future of a joy and peace on this earth. Giving him such a, I would say, a blessing to live and live in abundance on this earth until rapture and eternal, certainly. He is here to give us that hope. He is here to give us that faith. He is here to give us that victory, no matter who you are. Only believe in him. They didn't open their mouth. This is a moment of saving the life of a desperate man, a helpless man. And Jesus told that man, stretch forth your hand. That same right hand, he said, stretch forth. And the Bible says, when he stretched forth that hand, immediately that hand became whole, fully healed, beautiful hand like the other. That man did not say, sir, how can I lift this hand? I have no strength, I have no muscles, all are wasted, there is no blood flow, I have no life in this hand, how can I? He didn't use his own intelligence, he didn't use his own way of analyzing things. We waste time analyzing and imagining things. Oh, but Lord says, believe like a little child, only trust him. With God, all things are possible. With man, it is not possible. We can't do anything. But with Jesus, all things are possible. Matthew 19, verse 26. Luke 1, verse 37. He loves you. This man didn't open a mouth even. He didn't open his mouth. He didn't bring out his intelligence and knowledge and trying to explain to the Lord, Lord, do it this way or do it that way. Or he didn't say, Lord, you come and place your hand on me. No. The power of the love of Jesus, the power of the word of Jesus has totally taken hold of his mind, his thoughts. He just lifted the hand. The word of Jesus has power to create new blood cells, new muscles, new bones, new life into every one of us, into our spirit, soul and body. Even now, lift your hand and receive your miracle. Lift your hand and receive your peace. Lift your hand and receive your joy. Lift your hand and receive your life and healing. That hand became whole like the other hand. They were shocked. They were surprised. My loving children, today, the Lord is going to do that for you. Are you ready? Are you ready? God is going to call into being that which is not, as though it is there. He is God. He is our Creator, our Savior, our Redeemer. He is risen from the dead. He has defeated Satan, sin, death, hell, curse, and all darkness, pardoning us, forgiving us, saving us. Today he is providing all things for us. He is our provider. He is our protection, our shelter. Let not your heart be troubled. He loves you. God loves you. He is your Father, your Savior, your Redeemer, all of us, all of us. So at this time, my dear children, all we need is to believe him. Believe him for who he is. Believe him for who he is. Come to him for who he is. Trust him for who he is. He is our Savior, our God who lives, our Father who lives. Trust him for who he is. Come to him for who he is. Seek him for him. He loves you. He loves you. And these 2 minutes, as we listen to this powerfully anointed song by our one and only daughter Divina, Holy Spirit will come and take hold of our lives, our homes, our families, our personal lives, our thoughts, everything, our bodies. Let him take over. Let him take over. Trust him, trust him, trust him. Holy Spirit is the Spirit of the resurrected Jesus. 2 minutes, 2 minutes. You say, Lord, I need you. I seek you for you. I trust you for who you are. I have all the confidence in you for who you are, for my entire life, my future, my home, my family, my generation, the labor of my hands, my health, everything, my ministry, all of us until rapture and eternal. Trust him. He loves you, loves you, loves you. 2 minutes as we listen to this song. Just say, Lord, I need you. I need you. Holy Spirit, I need you. Fill me. Jesus, come and take hold of my life. I give it all to you. I let go everything of mine. I seek you, Lord. I trust you for who you are. I trust you for who you are. Thank you, Jesus. 2 minutes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Yes. As we trust Him for who He is in our lives, Jesus, our risen Savior and God, everything is going to be good for us as we take this new covenant, our Savior's covenant. Thank you, Lord, as Jesus took the bread, blessed it, break it, gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body that is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Jesus is risen with his body, our resurrected Lord. By his stripes we are healed, made whole. Jesus said, because I live, you shall live also. Thank you, Lord. And in like manner, he took the cup, gave thanks to God the Father, and gave it to the disciples and said, drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the new covenant that is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. That is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. That is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. And Jesus also said, do this in remembrance of me. And hence, hereafter, I will not drink of this fruit of the wine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. Until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. Until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. What a joy, what a blessed joy. The blood of Jesus cleanses me even now whiter than snow. You as we look unto our Father God in the name of Jesus. Father does everything through Christ Jesus. Jesus does it all for the glory of the Father. Holy Spirit does it all by His power for the glory of Jesus and the Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, as we humbly come to you through the new living way of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, your blood saving us, cleansing us, healing us, redeeming us, your life-giving blood, your life protecting us. Thank you, Holy Spirit, as you come upon your people. Thank you, giving them the peace, a great peace that fills them today, Lord, today. Thank you, Jesus, thank you. A great confidence in you, Jesus, a great confidence in you. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit is building that confidence, creating that confidence in their spirit, in their spirit, in their soul, in their mind. Confidence in Christ Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. A joy, a joy, a joy, a joy that God will do it. God will do it. My Father in heaven will do it in Jesus' name. A great confidence, a great faith is filling them. Life-giving faith, life-saving faith is today filling them, life-saving faith, life-giving faith. Life-healing faith is filling them. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Every defeated cancerous tumors are dissolved in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Every defeated throat pains, tonsillitis. Thank you, Jesus, is healed in Jesus' name. Every defeated pains in the bones, in the joints, in the neck, in the shoulders. Holy Spirit loosens you in Jesus' name. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Roslyn, receive. Thank you, Jesus, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord, thank you. Every defeated ailment in the stomach, in the stomach, in the stomach, in the intestines, anywhere, Holy Spirit is healing you in Jesus' name, for the glory of the Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus, thank you, thank you, thank you. Holy Spirit is doing it, quickening every cell of your body. Lift your hands and receive. Your mind is having that serenity and that confidence and that peace. Every defeated fear, every defeated anxieties, every defeated stress and tensions are leaving. The Father's love is delivering you for the glory of the Lord Jesus, for the glory of the Father. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, a great love. Thank you, Jesus, is healing your spine, your neck, your back, your waist. Holy Spirit is healing you in the name of Jesus for the glory of the Lord Jesus, the risen Savior. Resurrected power of Jesus is filling you. Every bone, every defeated paralysis, rheumatism, every defeated arthritis, all is broken apart. Jesus tells you, rise and stand in the midst. Rise and stand, rise and walk, rise. He's telling everyone to lift your hands. There is wholeness, healing happening. Deliverance. Jesus delivers you, Son of God delivers you and makes you whole physically, mentally, emotionally. Every defeated grief and hurt is totally removed by the love of Jesus. He is holding you by in your right hand. He is holding you and lifting you in every area, financially, family, children, anywhere, the labor of your hands, anywhere, peace in homes, peace and joy in families, everywhere, every defeated wrong thoughts and bad thoughts are washed out by the blood of Jesus. Thank you. He's healing you everywhere. Every blindness, partial blindness in the eyes, Jesus heals. Every defeated ailment in your ears, Jesus heals. Any organ, your mind, your thoughts, Jesus heals and makes you whole. Stretch forth your hand and receive your miracle. Stretch forth your hand and receive your life and life in abundance. Miracle life. Holy Spirit is healing you. Thank you. Jennifer, receive. Be whole. Be made whole. Healed. Jesus loves you everywhere. Prince, receive. He loves you. Anyone. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit is healing. Jonathan, receive. Everywhere, Holy Spirit is making you whole for the glory of Jesus, and the Father. Everywhere, there is a future now for you. There is a blessed future, a joyful future, a sure future for all of us until rapture and eternal with our families and generation. Jesus opens the door. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord is doing. George. Yes, the Lord is doing. There is a sure future. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Every defeated ailment in the legs, swellings, pain in the ankles, Jesus heals everywhere. Every defeated back pains, every defeated blood diseases, Jesus, with his one finger, casts out every pain, every agony, every mental tension, every heart palpitations. Jesus heals. Peace and a confidence. There is a sure future. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Everywhere for anyone in Jesus' name. Only believe. Trust him. Lift your hands and say, Lord, I trust you. Thank him. Begin to thank him. Lift your hands and thank him. Give him the praise. Give him the gratitude. Give him the glory. Holy Spirit is touching your tongue. Speak in tongues. Oh, those who are filled in the Holy Spirit, forget everything. Forget yourself. Holy Spirit is taking over every aspect of your life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Everywhere. Andrew, receive. Yes, though the Lord is doing it all. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Everywhere, river of life is flowing. Lift your hands and drink the river of life Jesus gives. Hallelujah. He loves you. He loves the broken heart and the contrite heart. He is lifting you. He's filling you. He's there for you, never to leave you. He is with us forever. Risen Savior. Only believe. There is hope today. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Hillary. Receive. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. No man, no man. Only to him, Jesus of Nazareth, risen Savior. Only to him, God our Father. Praise him, praise him. Thank him, thank him, thank him. Lift your hands and receive, receive, receive. Wherever you need your miracle. Rivers of living water, life-giving waters are flowing into your spirit, soul and body, home, family, everywhere, our future, our generation, until rapture and eternal, our ministries, all for the glory and the pleasure, and the pleasure and the glory of the Lord Jesus, risen Savior, living God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Glory to the Father in Jesus' name. Glory to the Father through Christ Jesus. Glory to the Father through Christ Jesus. Thank you, God. Amen, 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 amen. He loves you, loves you, loves you, loves you. Children, service will go on through as my dear son ministers powerfully, continuing in the same flow, and will continue and minister in the Holy Spirit and preach and minister and pray for anyone and say the benediction and complete the service. Dear ones, come every Sunday, every Sunday. Make it a point and bring new people, new people. Jesus heals the broken heart. Great miracles are happening, better than before. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. And the church is increasing, rising. Bring those who are in pain, agony. Jesus wipes away the tears. The tears are removed. Life, a new life, a blessed future until rapture and eternal. And one thing, beloved ones, so every Sunday, come, don't miss service. Very important in the house of Lord. When you are faithful, faithful in the house of the Lord, Lord is faithful in our house, in our homes. Important. So when we are faithful in the house of the Lord, He is manifesting Himself faithful in our house, our homes. Everyone, anyone, Jesus loves you. One more thing, beloved ones, the men's ministry is about to start. And my dear son, Gerard, will be leading in charge of the men's ministry and fully supported and helped and supported by our dear son Raj and also Michael. So they will be supporting Gerard and also my dear son Bandula also. So the men's ministry will be starting and under the leadership of Gerard and my son Pastor Anselm will have the pastoral overseeing and pastoral care will be by my dear son Pastor Anselm and even the other dear senior pastors, everyone. So the men's ministry is going to start. They will announce the date. So invite new men and new people. It'll be once a month. But the main service is important in the house of the Lord on Sunday. Jesus loves you, loves you, loves you. See you again, children. See you again. Always, always, until rapture and eternal. See you again. See you again. Jesus loves you, loves you, loves you. See you again until rapture and eternal.
This is Timothy. For 6 months, because of an injury, he's been having pain in his elbow. He couldn't bend it without pain. Today he says the pain is completely gone,
son. You couldn't do it before, child. It's completely gone. Lift your hands to Jesus and say thank you to Jesus. He loves you, son.
This is Reagan. For 6 months, Pastor, he's been suffering with a lump on his chest. Now the mother testifies that there's no sign of the lump. Completely gone. Completely healed.
No sign of the lump at all. For 6 months he had this child. It's gone now. You can press and show. Everything is fine. You are the mother. You know it. Who healed this dear little son? Even the minutest detail of everyone is taken care. He loves you, child. He loves you.